The Georgia Dome is always filled and rocking for the Chick-fil-A Bowl. A live look on the floor of the stadium right now as we close in on kickoff. Time for ESPN's College Football. Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit will be on the call. Brad, take it away.
This has the makings of being an incredible bowl game. Welcome to the Chick-fil-A Bowl. EA Sports and ESPN bring you this exciting college football game. Hi, everybody. I'm Brad Nessler, joined by Kirk Herbstreit, and we'll hear from Aaron Andrews on the sidelines and Reese Davis in the studio throughout the game. Today's exciting game is brought to you by Dove Men Plus Care. Be comfortable in your own skin. You'll see the Ohio State Buckeyes and the Georgia Bulldogs. And here come both teams. For Ohio State, they've got to be thinking this one could go either way.
These are the matchups you just love. These two teams are so much alike that it's got to be a really hard-fought and close game all the way.
It's time for the coin toss, presented by Dove Men Plus Care. Be comfortable in your own skin. See how these two teams play in this game as they prepare for the opening kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 10. Brought down at the 19-yard line. For Ohio State, is there anything we should be keeping an eye on?
With this spread attack, they like to have four or five wide receivers on the field at once. They get the quarterback in the shotgun and give him a lot of room to make decisions. He'll have to get good protection from his line to make things work there.
The defensive end just put on a clinic that time.
You know, they might want to double team this guy with the back the next time they pass.
Going long. He almost had it, but it's incomplete. From their own 19-yard line, third down. He drops back. And he's got it. Going the other way now. Gets a block on the corner. Great play there by the corner to come up with a big interception.
That's not a very good pass right there. He should probably have tried to throw that one away. He was under heavy pressure and then threw it right to the corner.
From the 34-yard line. First down. And he's taken down at about the 37-yard line.
Well, the defensive line got such a good push up front that there was no one on the offense to account for the linebacker. And he got through almost untouched.
From the 37-yard line, it's second down. That's a great tackle at the 32. Quick release, tight end, incomplete. It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. Georgia is looking to go up by three. It has the distance, and he got it.
Boy, he had plenty of distance there and pushed it through. Very impressive leg strength.
3-0, Georgia. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He boots it deep downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. They threw a pick the last time out. Should be interesting to see what they do this time.
So much in football is about how you respond to adversity. Moving forward after a turnover is a perfect example of that.
He gets hit out of bounds at the 41-yard line.
How about the big fellas up front? This line will have to continue to play like that to build the consistency to help this offense be effective.
Appears that he's changing things up here before the snap. He looks to throw on first down. He guns it left side. Great catch there before they can knock him out of bounds. Stroud running the option. He's tackled at the 34-yard line. He may have changed things up here. They go with the option. Nice gain as he works the right side. Possibly changing the play here prior to the snap. And he tackles him hard at the 20. And they pick up the first down with a pass to the tight end.
It's easy to forget about the tight end sometimes coming off the line, but you always have to watch this guy because he's certainly capable of making big plays.
Burton on the give. They'll bring him down around the 19-yard line. A 1 yard gain by the halfback. From the 19-yard line, second down. Gets to about the 17-yard line. He gains a couple of yards on the carry.
This guy is very physical, and he does a good job of taking on blockers.
We'll wait and see here if he really does change the play. Can't find anyone open. They bring him down.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
It's fourth down. So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. Ohio State is looking to tie things up. He gets it up, and he's got it. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He sends this one deep. He's to the 10. He's tackled at the 21.
I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation.
Now he's scrambling. And he dives forward. They're changing the play. Nearly picked off, but he couldn't hold it. From their own 26-yard line. Third down. Madden hits it on the inside. Tackle around the 39-yard line. Trying to change the play. And he's stopped behind the line.
By the time the running back here got the football, he's looking up, and he's got a couple defensive linemen closing in on him because they were able to slip off of their blocks. Really, there's nothing he could do at all there. That was more of a miscommunication and just getting overmatched up front by the offensive line.
He gets it out to about the 47-yard line. I think the defense jumped the gun a little bit on that play.
That's just a discipline thing there. It's 5 free yards, and that could hurt.
From their own 42-yard line, it's second down. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. Brought down around the 43-yard line. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
Looks like he might audible out of that play. He's taken down at the 40-yard line.
What a relief it is for a quarterback to know that he's got a receiver like this who can step up when he needs him on third down.
He's back to pass here on first down. Quick out to his receiver. And down he goes at the 30. So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
And they make the stop right around the 30. That was well defended by this defense.
The offensive line is so concerned with their penetrating abilities that these linebackers are able to roam free and make plays like that.
It's the ninth play of the drive. On the ground with the tailback. Tackle made at about the 19-yard line. That could be a check with me right there. Nice run there. Around the 14-yard line. Trying to confuse the defense here with the audible. He's on the run. And he's taken down around the 11-yard line. He scrambled, but he didn't get much.
Brad, this defense reacts too quickly for a scramble like that to work. He needs to spread him out a little bit more to try to create more room to run.
Fourth down, they'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. Kicks up, and it's good.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. They'll take over at the 25-yard line. Stroud on the run. Makes it to the 34. And it looks like they're going to change it up here. Quick throw, incomplete, one of his receiver. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. He passes it. That close to being intercepted.
Smart, heady play by that defender. That was solid, fundamental pass defense.
Jackson is the deep man awaiting the return. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Talk about a booming punt. My goodness.
Again, it's about stressing special teams. That is why a lot of head coaches usually run these units. It's because field position is just so important in the game.
Georgia holds a field goal lead. He's tackled at the 4-yard line. A yard, maybe two on the carry. And he might change the play here before the snap. Slings it. They'll bring him down around the 9-yard line. He might be playing a cat and mouse game here with the defense.
Hands it to the back. Up the middle for a nice gain.
They didn't try to just force something there. Just good, hard running for the first down.
They're calling an audible. Heading for the corner. Tackle right around the 20.
And he doesn't like what he sees. He's going to change the play here.
He gets out to about the 22-yard line. He's changing things up. They'll run it. He makes his way out to about the 35. From their own 35-yard line, it's first down. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. The Bulldogs taking their first time out of the half. This is the eighth play of this drive. Georgia is up by three. On the ground, inside. And they get him in the backfield for a loss. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. Pickup of a yard for the tailback.
They've got 10 guys up. They're coming after the kick.
Brought down at the 31. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. And he's level at the 41. Back to pass. Feeling the pressure and he fumbles the football. To the 10. Brought down at the 6-yard line. So the offense turns over the pigskin.
The ball carrier here was just careless in handling the ball. And a great awareness by the defense to jump on it.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. He's gobbled up in the backfield.
Did you see how that big defensive line got such a good push on that play? That's exactly why they were able to stop him for a loss.
Georgia has a 3-point lead. Back to pass. Almost intercepted there. It's third down. They need 8 yards here to get the ball in the end zone. He drops back. And he hits him hard at the 2-yard line. This one should be makeable. The kick is up, and he got it.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
They
They line up to kick this one away. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 10. He's taken down at the 28-yard line.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
They'll throw on first down. He scrambles. And he is drilled at the 40.
I'm telling you, quarterbacks who can run the ball are so hard to stop. You have to scheme around them, which takes the best coverages out of your defensive playbook. Cut.
Drops back to pass. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. He's at midfield. He's pushed out of bounds at the 42.
I think a key in being able to throw a good screen pass is the quarterback selling it, looking downfield as if he's going to throw the ball downfield, knowing he's about to retreat and just dump it to his running back. So I think the quarterback is the key, being able to time it up, wait for that pressure to get to him, and then wait to the last possible second to deliver the football to the receiver or running back.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 42.
Cut. He lets it fly. And he hauls that one in.
This guy just continues to impress me. Every time I watch this team play, he seems to come up with big plays.
The kicker on the field. He'll try to put his team up by a point. He makes the PAT. It was a quick three-play, 72-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
I tell you what, we've seen some games over the last few years where defenses just let a game get away from them. Right now, this defensive coordinator better get a timeout and get his defense focused, because right now they couldn't look any worse.
So the score now, 10-9. They'll start at the 25. He makes it to the 25-yard line. Well, we've played a half of football. The Buckeyes lead it by one. Well, can these two defenses keep this pace up? Or will the offenses start to kick in? We're about to find out as we open up the second half. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. For Georgia, they're on the losing end of a tight score, so this drive might set the tone. For more, let's send it down to Aaron.
Minor tweaks, Brad. That's what the coaches told me as he took his team into the locker room. He said they're not far off from what they need to do to win this game.
And for Ohio State, they feel that if their run defense plays at this level in the second half, they'll be in a good position entering the fourth quarter. Back up to you, Brad.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Would have been a big play by the defense. He can't hold it. Second and 10. Ball on the 25. Back to pass. He unloads it. Third down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 25. On the run. And he tackles him hard at the 27. Brown will be the return man. He really got a hold of that one.
makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line. Pretty good job by the return man there. And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Ohio State with a one-point lead. Gets it. He's in space. He's taken down at the 49-yard line.
I think it was a great play call, and it was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
Here's the option. He makes it out to midfield. Appears that he's changing things up here before the snap. On the throw, incomplete pass. Jackson, back to return it. It's away, and it's a booming punt. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Possibly changing the play here prior to the snap. Here's the run. Got a hold. And they make the stop at the 34-yard line. He may have changed things up here. Inside give. Nice run, and he's brought down. Trying to confuse the defense here with the audible. Tackle made right around the 38-yard line.
That's a great play by the defense. There's nothing like a defense being able to slip off of a block, get into the backfield of the offense, and then make a play in the backfield to be able to create some momentum possibly for this defense.
They try the option, left side.
They get a little sloppy here with their ball handling. It's a good thing they were near the sideline. Otherwise, the defense could have pounced on that football.
Thorson to punt. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line. Made a few guys miss on his way to a quality return. They'll get the ball here at the 24-yard line. Ohio State up a point. Burton gets it on the inside. Nice run there. Stroud drops back. He's hit and taken down. And a nice pickup there.
I'll tell you what, the defense gambled a bit here and came with the blitz, and a quarterback showed tremendous poise by making a good read and delivered a nice ball to the open man.
Option right. On the pitch, look out, loose ball. The defense has it. Kirk, what happened on the option play there?
Well, you got to give credit to the defense. They knew what was coming, and they came up and made the play.
And they'll look to capitalize on the good field position here. They go with the back, and he's got room. He's at the 30.
Good, solid running right there. Getting past a defensive lineman and into the secondary before he could be stopped.
That could be a check with me right there. And he's stopped behind the line.
Think about the speed and instincts it takes for a linebacker to get from his position into the backfield to make a play like that. That's well done.
From the 21-yard line, it's second down. On the handoff, watch out. Inside the 10.
He just put his eyes on that end zone and ran with some real purpose there.
So the offense will stay on the field and attempt the two-point conversion. Defense in their short yardage package. He's in for the conversion.
A quick two-play, 20-yard drive, and they get 8 points after that two-point conversion.
Brad, not only did they put points up on the board, but I think it's the way they did it. That could be demoralizing for defense.
Georgia gets set to kick this one away. And this is just a booming kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. So can the defense match their effort from the last drive with another takeaway?
The last possession didn't go in the favor for this offense. I'd expect to see them come out and be a little bit more conservative with some safe play calling in order to avoid another bad result.
That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
Try to change the play. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. They'll bring him down at about the 39-yard line.
That was actually pretty good defense. But a great pass and a great catch were enough to overcome it.
He might be playing a cat-and-mouse game here with the defense. That's a great tackle at the 45. They're calling an audible. Option. He's tackled at the 46. He's looking to pass. Pulls it in and gets out of bounds. From the 48-yard line, first down. He looks to throw on first down. He throws right. Almost intercepted.
Man, I don't know if this quarterback misread the defense or just made a poor decision, but that wasn't a pass he should have thrown.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 48-yard line. Brought down at about the 43-yard line. Royer gains about 5 yards on the play. Here's the option. And down he goes at about the 41. Called his own number on that one.
I like the idea of trying to run here, but the defense really made him pay the price for trying to run.
It's fourth down. They call on the kicker for a long field goal. So with one quarter remaining, the Bulldogs lead 17-10. Fourth down. It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. He drops back. And the safety with the interception. Oh, no. They really didn't need that.
And as a quarterback, you can't give up an interception late in the game. You got to be more careful with the football.
First and 10, ball on the 36. Georgia up 7 points. First down and back to pass. He's out of bounds at the 39. And here's a quick throw. This one will fall incomplete. From their own 39-yard line, third down. Scrambling around, and he's taken down around the 48-yard line.
Hey, sometimes the defense does everything right, and they still lose. That time they had tight coverage, which left no options other than for the quarterback to take off.
And he's tackled around the 50-yard line. Tackled after a decent run up the gut. Looks to pass. Caught, open field. Tackle around the 41-yard line. Short throw over the middle, and it's picked off. He's at the 30. The 10. Touchdown, Ohio State.
How about the play by the defender? That was a great interception and an even better effort to bring the ball back for a touchdown.
They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. And he adds the extra point. Just under 4 minutes to go in the game. The score is tied up at 17. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. This drive will start at the 25. He makes it to the 28-yard line. To him before he could get back to the line. From their own 26-yard line, it's third down. Throws it deep. Doesn't get there.
Accuracy is such a vital part of being a quarterback. You've got to have an ability to lay the ball right into your guy's hands.
Just under three to go in regulation. And this one is a beauty. Sheds a tackler. Knocked out of bounds around the 38-yard line. They'll go to work at the 38. They're going to pitch it. He's at midfield. At the 30. He's taken down around the 25-yard line.
Yeah, I love this offensive coordinator. I've always really appreciated his approach to the game. He's a little bit unorthodox in his approach, and this time he gives the wide receiver a chance to carry the football to pick up a first down.
Zips it to the tight end. Big play, and it's first and goal. Looks like he might audible out of that play. Stroud gets the ball. He makes it to the 9. And he might change the play here before the snap. He's got it with room to run. Touchdown, Bucks!
That was a big touchdown to not only give these guys the lead, but now the other team will need at least a touchdown to get back in this game.
Splits the uprights with the extra point. So a short three-play, 25-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard. So our score, 24-17. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Let's see what they can do on offense as they take possession after the return.
With it being a one-possession game and over 2 minutes to go in this game, there needs to be some urgency from this offense. But at the same time, you can't panic. You can't force the issue. Let the game come to you, but have some urgency to you to try to give yourself a chance at a touchdown here at the end.
Just over 2 minutes in the game. Option right side. Tackle made around the 35-yard line. He's changing things up. And they make the stop at the 48.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
Trying to confuse the defense here with the audible. Madden on the inside handoff. Nice run there. They hand it off again. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Georgia is going to use their first time out of the half here. Third down again. He heaves it to the end zone. Can't connect.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
This might be their last chance. Fourth down. This is their last chance. They need a big play here. And he makes it out to about the 41-yard line.
Pound for pound, this is a very solid offensive line. They know that if they do their job, they'll make enough room for short conversions.
Under a minute left in the game. He's scrambling. Fumble, loose ball. Diving for extra yardage. And that one's recovered by the cornerback.
Funny, because you usually don't see corners down there picking up loose balls. They're more worried about interceptions.
They'll start at the 26-yard line. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. He'll go down to one knee. The Bulldogs using their third and last timeout. So it's second and 12. Ball on the 24-yard line. The quarterback takes a knee, and that's always a good sign if you're a fan of this team. From their own 22-yard line, third down. Burton on the give. Gets out to around the 32. Really great game to watch. Both teams should be proud of their efforts in this one. 24-17, Ohio State. Kirk, go ahead and just give us your reflections on this game.
Well, this one really could have gone either way. Georgia played a good game out there, but they needed to make one or two more big plays, and they couldn't do it. Who knows? Another couple of minutes, and this one may have gone the other way.
Take a look at our choice for today's player of the game. He made a big contribution to his team's win. For EA Sports, Kirk Herbstreit and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying thank you for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.